What is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten till date?
A grasshopper.
So Tapsee Pannu has eaten a grasshopper. Can you believe it? Sunday brunch with the Delhi girl Tapsee Pannu
in a Japanese restaurant.
And if I know Delhiites correctly, yeah. They love food.
Yeah.
Are you also a true blue Delhiite?
Oh yeah, I live to eat. I actually live to eat. Food decides my mood, my momentum of the day. It's always, my life is planned around my what kind of food I'm eating in breakfast, lunch, dinner, or wherever I am. So it's like, planning for food starts much before my planning for any other trip.
Really?
Like, okay. Yeah, what I'm going to do is like primarily around my food.
And you're also a traveler. So are you a bigger foodie or a bigger traveler?
I think bigger foodie.
A bigger foodie, okay. So we've got you at the right place. And tell me, being from Delhi, all of Delhi loves street food. So do you have any favorite street food that keeps calling you back to Delhi?
Of course, I don't eat chole bhature outside Delhi. My calories should be worth it. And chole bhature can't be my everyday food.
Right.
My next best is Japanese food because you can literally eat it every day. There was a point that I was so obsessed with it that I was actually having sushi every day. So yeah, I'm that, and that too, lunch and dinner both. So,
and what about sarsoda saag, makke di roti?
No, all that is seasonal. Okay, so I don't know this myth about all Punjabi sadar families eating sarso ka saag and makke ki roti day and night doesn't happen like that. It has a season during winters is when you actually eat that.
This is also the season, so have you had your sarso da
saag
for
had
this
at
season
home.
Already?
Yes, I have been, yeah.
And I believe it's been quite some time that you haven't had wheat, milk or curd. And I don't know of too many Punjabis out there who don't have milk because ek doodh ka glass to chahiye.
Yeah, I've been brought up with like 3 glasses of milk a day. When you wake up, then before going to school, then at the during evening before you go to play, and then before sleeping. So these were the 3 staple, and then dahi has to be there in your breakfast and your lunch, not in dinners though. So I have been brought up, and dinners might have raita. So I have been brought up with this kind of diet my entire life, but only to later on realize that this is not what really works for my body. So I had to change my diet, and it really showed results, is why I could stick to it.
Yeah. Do you miss it?
Little bit, but not to an extent that I'm ready to compromise over how the kind of result it's showing on me.
Yeah. So kuch paane ke liye kuch khona padta hai.
100%. Itna compromise kar sakti hu. I have my substitutes.
Right.
So if I don't eat wheat, I end up eating other types of flour like bajra or barley or something or the other. And then in milk, I end up having almond milk. So it's not like I totally like I'm depriving myself of that particular food. I'll have an alternate.
Yeah, and now you love Japanese food, so it's great. I'm going to test your love for Japanese food to begin with.
Let's please don't ask me to use chopsticks because that's definitely not... let's address the elephant in the room. I don't know how to use chopsticks.
Ooh.
And I have refused to learn because it... My concentration is way too much on not dropping the food than eating it if I'm using chopsticks. So many times, so many people are like, no, don't worry, we'll teach you, it's easy and all that. I'm like, I don't want to learn.
And interestingly, for sushis, you don't need to really use chopsticks.
Exactly. So let's eat Japanese food the Japanese way. And that is using your hands.
We have a giant sushi boat. And I'm going to help you with this. Now you need to guess which sushi is it.
I think it's uramaki because it's got something on the outside also. I think so. I don't know.
You're right. This is uramaki. Well done.
There's one more in the plate. Here.
Yes. This? Oh, this is sashimi.
Oh, yes. Well done. You clearly know your Japanese food really well.
Okay.
Now you have earned your sushi.
Oh my God. Thank God. Finally. Can I have a fork?
Yes,
can I take this fork, please?
Yeah, please.
Exactly, did you develop this love for Japanese food?
I think after I left Delhi is when I tried Japanese food. And obviously in the first go, you don't really understand this raw food.
Mm.
But a very close friend of mine, Farah.
Yeah.
So she introduced me to this and Maharashtrian, like local cuisine.
Yeah.
And I don't know, after a couple of times, I developed the taste and I really started enjoying it, strangely. And since then, I've been almost addicted to it.
What is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten till date?
A grasshopper.
Wow, when and where was that? So Tapsee Pannu has eaten a grasshopper. Can you believe it?
It's not something I'm very proud of, but it's just that if you ask me the weirdest thing that I've eaten, then that is it. That was in during one of my Scandinavian holidays.
Hmm.
And it was just like those fried grasshopper and worms. And yeah, I mean, I ate them.
But what, did someone challenge you or did you voluntarily go to try?
No, it was there and people were eating it, so I wanted to just also try.
How does it taste?
Actually, nothing. It doesn't taste like anything because when they're fried, it literally becomes like a chip. So when you eat it, you have no taste.
Okay, I want to ask all our viewers, would you ever try a grasshopper? Leave your comments below because I'm very curious to know if how many people would actually do that. I'm not so experimental with food, to be honest. Have you ever been to Japan to try the authentic Japanese food?
So that's the only thing left in my bucket list.
Okay.
In terms of Japan and Japanese food, I wanted to have local Japanese food there in Tokyo or wherever I go to in Japan. The thing is that my tolerance level for weather is not too good. So,
okay.
In terms of cold weather.
Right.
So, if it's too cold, I can't really take it. So I'm waiting for that time when I'll have time during summers of Japan to go there and have all this. But that is definitely in my bucket list, yeah.
Last time when we spoke, you mentioned that your favorite travel partner is your sister Shagun. So, is she still your favorite travel partner?
Yeah, she is still. Thankfully, my happy traveling partner because we both have similar taste in food, in things in general. So we both like to travel together. We have similar kind of lifestyle.
We have more Japanese food coming in.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot of food.
That's a lot of food actually.
And honestly speaking, my understanding of Japanese food starts and ends at sushi. I never knew there is so much more to Japanese
There's
food.
There's a lot. There is a lot. That carpaccio you should try. It's really, really good.
Tapsee, do you enjoy such interviews where you also get to eat?
Yeah.
Have you ever had an interview like this before?
I don't remember.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, I really enjoy doing eating scenes also.
What about your home-cooked meal? What is it that your mom cooks that you truly enjoy?
What I really want her to cook every time I go home is mutter paneer.
Hmm.
She cooks really good mutter paneer and I really enjoy that. And there is this particular type of breakfast menu for us as a kid when we used to go to school. She used to make these bread pizzas for us.
You spent most of your childhood in Delhi. What is the primary difference that you would see between a Delhi and a Mumbai, especially when it comes to food?
I've enjoyed my street food meals in Delhi, which honestly I don't as much. Maybe because I would, in Mumbai I don't enjoy that as much. Maybe because I develop a really strong taste of Delhi street food.
Yeah.
So whenever my friends used to take me out for street food in Mumbai, I didn't used to enjoy it.
Do you like vada pav? Have you tried vada pav? You don't.
Tried.
I've tried. I couldn't really get the taste. I didn't really enjoy it as much as I expected to.
You would rather prefer chole bhature over vada pav any day.
Yeah. Actually, I would prefer chole bhature over 99% of things any day.
Do you still eat?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Because my calories should be worth it. It shouldn't be like, I mean, if I don't feel like it's tasty enough, I will not just eat it for the sake of having chole bhature.
Yeah.
But I know since I've been, I mean, every area in Delhi has its own chole bhature wala or its own golgappe wala that you have to eat.
Yeah.
So it's nothing like that one is better than this one.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it is. Every area will have its own and all will be equally good. So there's this Hari Om chole bhature wala near my house.
Mm.
And since school time, I've been having chole bhature from there and they're still equally good. And even now when I go home, At least once we'll get breakfast from there as Chole Bhature.
So is the Hari Om Chole Bhature in Rohini? Where or?
Prashant Vihar.
Okay.
It's right next to my sector in Rohini. Prashant Vihar is a small area, almost like in the premises of Rohini. Near Pitampura, Rohini area. Yeah. So it's quite near to my sector in Rohini because Rohini has sectors.
Yeah.
So Prashant Vihar is right next to mine.
Do you cook?
No, I don't.
Not at
I
all.
Only eat.
And
my concentration is only on food. Three things you say when you are surprised.
Oh my god. Umaki, temaki.
You don't hear that.
Pretty much. It sounds very similar to the Japanese sushi names.
Very smart.